House Speaker Nancy Pelosi announcing the creation of a select House committee to investigate the January 6th Capitol riot, this following the failure last month of a bipartisan effort to form an independent commission in the Senate. Joining me now to weigh in, Ohio Congressman Jim Jordan. Mr. Jordan, it's always wonderful having you here on the program. Let's start here. It seems Pelosi wants to investigate the January 6th riots, but wants to ignore a year and a half of riots from her political base. I don't know about you, but I'm getting really tired of socialist double standard when it comes to enforcement of the law.
Yeah, well, I mean, you're right. There's always a double standard with the Democrats. But, I mean, frankly, Chris, what else does she have to talk about? What else do Democrats have to talk about? They're going to talk about inflation. The price of every good and service has gone up. The price of, you know, raw material, lumber, steel, aluminum, copper. I mean, so they're going to talk about that. They're going to talk about the crisis on the border. They're going to talk about the fact that there was peace in the Middle East under President Trump. And then we had rockets fired, thousands of rockets fired on our best friend and ally, Israel. They're going to talk about the fact that employers, every single employer I talk to, can't find employees. Are they going to talk about the fact they're getting ready to raise your taxes? So I don't know what else they have to talk about. So they got to focus on January 6th. Everyone sees it for what it is. It's crazy that they continue to focus there. Look, what happened was wrong, and people who did wrong should be held accountable. We've said that. We said that about people last fall. We said that about what happened on January 6th. You know, this is just the way the Democrats operate. They got nothing else to speak about, so they're going to focus on January 6th.
Well, maybe the Democrats could talk about their cozy relationship with communist China. A new report from The Pulse is revealing that Google and the USAID-funded Wuhan scientist Peter Daszak's bat virus experiments for more than a decade. And you add to this, Google now admitting that they censored Republicans and scientists during the pandemic to limit the information that we, the people, had access to. How much longer will Congress cower before Google and other big tech companies, Congressman, because they appear to be doing some real damage?
Yeah. No, we got a good plan. It's interesting, though, first that you know, Google working with Daszak, and then, of course, we had Zuckerberg working with Fauci. And when we got the emails, a bunch of it's redacted. This is just one of the many reasons why we do have to break up big tech, hold them accountable. We got a plan, Republicans, not the one the Democrats brought forward, which basically empowers Joe Biden lefties at the Federal Trade Commission. We got a plan that would really focus in on accountability, transparency, and speed. Speed. We want the Trump Department of Justice and FTC antitrust actions that the Trump administration brought, we want them to get right to the Supreme Court. So we want to expedite that. We want to take away the liability protection big tech has. We want to allow a private right of action so you can hold them accountable. And then we want transparency. Every single time that anyone gets censored or their content gets taken down, there should be an explanation from these folks. So that's the kind of legislation Republicans are putting together, not what the Democrats did the past couple of days, where they worked with the four key Democrat impeachment managers to pass legislation that's going to empower the FTC to, I think, marry up big tech and big government to further harm conservatives.
Oh, good grief. Let's hope wisdom prevails somewhere. The Wall Street Journal is reporting Chinese researchers directed the U.S. National Institutes of Health to delete a gene sequence of the early China virus in a key scientific database. Just like Google is accused of doing, we're learning that there was an active effort to hide information. Question: if China did nothing wrong, why are they working so damn hard to cover their tracks, Congress?
Yeah, no kidding. I mean, every time we turn around, it seems like stuff that we think makes sense, stuff that we think is accurate, you got someone in the government or somebody or the media at all, or maybe many times all of them working together to say it's not actually the truth, when in fact we then subsequently learn that it was accurate, it was factual, it was the truth. And certainly this whole origins of the virus, when they were downplaying the lab leak theory, it sure looks like that's the case now. And it also, frankly, looks like that there was probably gain-of-function research going on at this lab funded by American taxpayers. And as you now point out, China misleading us on what was actually taking place. So that shouldn't surprise us. The left is wrong about everything. They work together with big media. We see that time and time again with all these big stories where they tell us one thing. It turns out with a little time, we learn it wasn't actually true.
Well, Congressman, it looks like the spirit of Lois Lerner is back at the Internal Revenue Service. I don't know if you heard about this story, but they withheld tax-exempt status from a Texas Christian group claiming that Christianity is basically Republican. Now, first off, I want you to comment on the religious discrimination of the Internal Revenue Service, but then also comment on the IRS confirming that only the GOP exhibits Christian values.
Well, maybe they're right about some. No, I shouldn't say that. There's Christians in the Democrat Party too. But yeah, it's actually worse than that, though, because remember, Lois Lerner, what she said was, oh, these tax-exempt conservative groups were coming forward and say, or these conservative groups were coming forward applying for tax-exempt status. Lois Lerner said, we're going to make you wait. And they harassed them and made them wait, but they didn't really make a decision. They put it off, and then I guess putting it off is somewhat of a decision. Today in the Biden IRS, it's just much worse because they said, oh, you're applying for tax-exempt status? No, we're not giving it to you, and we're not giving it to you because you're a Christian organization. So that's, in some ways, I think that's worse than even what Lois Lerner did, which sort of underscores just how wrong this administration's been on just about everything. I've never, in my lifetime, never seen an administration had a worse start, a worse 5 months to a start of administration than the Biden administration. And again, that's why they're talking about January 6th, because they got nothing else to talk about.
Yeah, and very quickly, Congressman, isn't it illegal to discriminate based on religion? Why is the IRS allowed to discriminate based on religion?
They're not. It's straight out of the First Amendment. But again, this is something I talk a lot about because it scares me, Chris. Every single liberty we enjoy under the First Amendment has been attacked. Every single one. Right to practice your religion, right to assemble, right to petition your government, freedom of the press, freedom of speech, every single one. There are still congregations that can't meet in full today in America because of government. A few weeks ago, 5 weeks ago, I spoke to the New Mexico Republican Party in Amarillo, Texas, because they couldn't assemble in their own state. They had to come to Texas to get freedom. That is how crazy the left has become. So Anytime we see infringements on the First Amendment, we got to speak out. And I appreciate you doing that every night on your show.
Congressman Jim Jordan, we appreciate you, sir. Thank you for fighting the good fight up there on Capitol Hill.
Hey, I'm Rob Finnerty. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please join the conversation in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe, too. Hit the bell icon to be alerted to breaking news. And remember, there's a whole lot more on Newsmax TV, America's fastest growing cable news network. Newsmax TV, where real news for real people.